Hey, what's up, Versus Nerds? This is Justin, and I'm back with another deck profile. This time I'm going to build a deck around my favorite character. So who is that? Is it Spider-Man? No. Is it Captain America? Eh, might be getting a little close. Wolverine? No. It's this guy. Major Victory. That's right, he's actually my favorite character. I've loved this character since I was a kid. Collected all the OG Guardians of the Galaxy, and now I can actually play him in Versus System. And I'm really excited about that, until I found out that he kind of sucks. But I want to build a deck, I want to be able to use him, and so this is what I came up with. So this is my Major Victory deck. And there he is, Major Victory. He's got the power Psychokinetic Shove. During the main phase, for an intellect, push an enemy character to its back row. He has range and 2 attack, 4 defense, 1 health. He's a 2-cost character. I gotta say, being a Major Victory fan, this was a disappointing card. The power is okay, but it's not gonna be used in many decks. It's not very versatile. And also, it is a little bit expensive to cost an intellect just to get this power off. But it can be useful in the right circumstances. For instance, if you need someone in the back row, for example, if you're playing Electra, or if you want to get someone out of the way, if someone has flight and you want to get to their back row, that's a good way to make that happen. I did try it in an Electra deck, and it didn't work because Electra is a very bad main character to play, and so then I ended up retooling it. And so this deck is based around Professor Xavier. He's an X-Men character. He has the power Cerebro. During the build phase, for an energy, reveal the top 5 cards of your deck, put a character from among them into your hand and the rest on the bottom in any order. And his level up condition is a Dream of Peace for 4 XP. At the end of your turn, if you didn't make any attacks this turn, Professor X gains an XP. Which is a little bit tricky to play because the way that you win in Versus System is by making attacks, and so you have to wait 4 turns before you can actually start attacking, which leaves you pretty vulnerable, but there should be enough in this deck to keep you protected. And then when he levels up to level 2, he gains the power Mental Domination. So during the main phase, for an intellect, ready a face-up enemy character and move it to your front or back row. At the end of your turn, move it back. That's an extremely strong power. You can basically steal your enemy's characters and take them off their board, and then you can use them against them, and you want to try to go for the KO so that you KO their two of their characters at once. Mental Domination is a pretty good power to have. So you can already start to see that we are building this deck around a control theme. So Major Victory has his Psychokinetic Shove, so he can push an enemy character. Professor X has Mental Domination, so he can steal an enemy character. And you can also see what I mean when I say that Major Victory's power is kind of expensive for what it does, because in the early game, I'm probably not going to be wasting my intellects on pushing enemy characters to the back row, when in the late game I can actually steal my enemy's characters and use them against them. So you can see that Professor X's power is a lot more significant compared to Major Victory's. So I built this deck around Major Victory, and in the end he's still not a great character. But this deck is fun, and so we will continue on. I have 4 Major Victories, by the way, so they will all be in this deck and increase my chance of drawing my favorite character. So let's back up. Major Victory is a 2-cost. We'll start out with our 1-cost Iceman. He has the power of Freeze. When he appears, exhaust a character it can't ready during its next turn. So again, keeping control of your opponent's characters by freezing them, pushing them, pulling them, etc. Got 4 Iceman. This is pretty standard for a lot of decks, so no surprises there. I also threw in a Leviathan Demolisher, one-of-a-kind creature. has the power Cometfall. When Leviathan Demolisher appears, put a -1/-1 counter on each enemy character. And also Tectonic Impact. When Leviathan Demolisher appears, turn an enemy location face down. So that prevents your opponent from using their powers. This is the one location control card that I have in this deck, and it's mostly for additional flavor. I had an extra slot, so I threw it in there. But at the 6 cost level, you could also throw in Iron Patriot, and he turns locations face down as well. There are probably other cards you could do, but this is the only one in this particular deck. But there's an option for you. At level 3 cost, I have Medusa. She has Grab. While Medusa is in the front row, enemy characters can't fly over her. And so that's good for controlling what your opponent can and can't do. And then Prehensile Hair, during the main phase for a skill, exhaust a front row enemy character. It can't ready or be moved until Medusa gets stunned or leaves play. So it's kind of like freeze on steroids. It's a little bit more expensive because you need the skill location to do it, but it can at least tie up your opponent a little bit if you play it right. So I have 2 Medusas in here, and I also have 2 Mesmeros. He has Hyper Hypnosis. The first enemy characters that attacks each turn has Lumbering. As it attacks, the defending player chooses who the defender is. So this is really good for controlling your opponent's actions. So every time they attack first, then I get to choose who they're going to attack against. So I can either send them up against someone with a high defense, like Mesmero, or I can send them into someone who's really weak, and basically I get to decide how that strategy plays out. I have not actually played this deck with Mesmero in it, so there's a little disclaimer for you. This is actually new for this deck profile. I did play it with Scarlet Spider in there. I had 2 Scarlet Spiders. He has Climb. At the start of your main phase, you may exhaust a location on your side. If you do, put a +1/+1 counter on Scarlet Spider. And Paralytic Darts. For a skill, choose an enemy supporting character. That character is immobile. It can't move during its formation step. And he has 2 health. So this is pretty good because it doesn't specify an end time, and so that character is immobile forever. That would make Scarlet Spider pretty decent, and there are skill locations in this deck, so that's something that you could run. I wanted to try out Mesmero, but there's a couple options. I just think Mesmero sounds like he could be really annoying for players to go up against, so there's a couple different ways you can play it, either 2 Mesmero or 2 Scarlet Spider. But you'll probably want to save your skill locations for other characters. At the 4 cost, we have 2 copies of Spider-Man. He has Dodge. He can't be ranged attacked. Again, deciding what your opponent can and can't do against your characters. And he has Web Sling for a skill. Again, pull a back row enemy character to its front row. So this is actually a pretty good complement to Major Victory, who pushes an enemy character to its back row. Spider-Man kind of does the opposite. And I initially had 4 Spider-Men in my deck, but one of my playing buddies gave me the idea of throwing Karma in there, or trying her out. So again, I haven't tried with Karma, but I have tried with 4 Spider-Man. And Karma has passive, so she can't attack or strike back. And also Possess Mind. When Karma appears, choose an enemy supporting character to gain passive until Karma gets stunned or leaves play. So, of course, passive means that your opponent's character also can't attack or strike back. So that's a good way for tying up your opponent and taking control of their side of the board. So I'm really excited to try her out in my next go-around with this deck. And one more 4-cost character is the Savage Leviathan. One-of-a-kind creature with Cometfall. When Savage Leviathan appears, put a -1/-1 counter on each enemy character. In Staggering Impact, when Savage Leviathan appears, you may push a front-row enemy character to its back row. So once again, friend to Major Victory, pushing characters to the back row. Staggering Impact is really nice because it doesn't cost an intellect, in order to play it. So, pretty disappointed with Major Victory, but happy to play with him. And one more character to shame Major Victory. At the 5-cost level, Purple Man has Brainwash for an intellect. Exhaust an enemy supporting character and move it to your back row. When Purple Man gets stunned or leaves your side, if that character is still on your side, move it to its owner's back row. So this one's really good because Purple Man can steal your opponent's characters, and again, you can either run them into their other characters and get them stunned so they leave play, or there's a more generous end target for Purple Man, which is when he gets stunned or leaves your side. Whereas Professor X, with his mental domination, at the end of your turn you have to move that character back to your enemy's side. Purple Man actually keeps them until Purple Man is basically out of play. So he can be really strong, and again, his use of this intellect location is going to get you a lot more than Major Victory's pushing with his intellect. So it's kind of a shame that Major Victory is so underpowered, but it's awesome that Purple Man has this power. It makes the deck really fun, and it makes your opponent really sad. So I've got 4 Purple Man in this deck. Also, at the 5-cost arena, I put in Quicksilver. He has mobile once per turn during your main phase, but not during combat. You may move Quicksilver to your front or back row. And stealth, Quicksilver can melee attack back row characters even while they're protected. This one is less about controlling your opponent and just having a little bit more control on your side. Mobile is nice because you can keep Quicksilver a little bit more protected. He can make an attack and then he can move into your back row, and you can keep him safe a little bit. And the fact that he can melee attack back row characters is also really useful. So let's compare to Major Victory, who can push an enemy character to its back row, and then Quicksilver could stealth attack it. You don't really need to do that, but, you know, there's a little combo in there, I guess. At the 6-cost, we have Magneto. He has flight and range and magnetic suppression. Enemy supporting characters can't recover, they remain stunned. So, again, trying to control your opponent's board. If they can't recover their characters, then they can't attack you, and that leaves you safe, that leaves Magneto safe, that leaves Professor X safe. It's just a really good character to have on hand in the 6-cost area. Like I said earlier, you could swap him out for Iron Patriot, who I think has similar stats and flight and range and can turn an enemy location face down, so it kind of depends on what you want to do there. But magnetic suppression is really good. So I have 4 copies of Magneto in this deck. And for 7 is Omega Red. He has Grab. While Omega Red is in the front row, enemy characters can't fly over him. And Carbonadium Tentacles. During the main phase, for a skill, choose up to 2 enemy characters Omega Red could melee attack on one side. For each one, daze it or it can't strike back this turn. So this is really good for getting enemies out of the way, KOing them, or just, you know, sort of hiding them, like a Gilgamesh or an Ares or something like that that's just annoying you and it's hard to get rid of. You can at least temporarily get rid of them with this power. And he's one of the primary reasons why I took the extra Spider-Man and Scarlet Spiders out of this deck, is because they also use the skill locations for their powers. And I would rather save those for this one, which is a lot more powerful. And there's some good replacements that I had for these for still maintaining control of your opponent's side. So I've got 2 of those Omega Reds in this deck. At the 8, we've got Fin Fang Foom. He's solitary, so he can't team attack, and massive. Fin Fang Foom attacks rows instead of characters. He strikes with his full attack against each defender in a row. So he's pretty good because he can attack lots of characters at once. He can be foiled if there's one character in a row that can't be attacked, then Fin Fang Foom won't be able to attack that row at all. But generally speaking, you know why you like Fin Fang Foom. one of those in this deck. Dark Phoenix at turn 9, flight, range, and 2 health, beefy stats, has the power, the keyword power, Deconstruct the Universe. When you recruit Dark Phoenix, you may remove one of the following concepts from the game. And there's the list there. If you're playing this, you know what this card does. And again, really good for controlling what your opponent can and can't do. So one of those in this deck. And of course, this is great for controlling what your opponent can't do. The Nullifier, Ultimate Nullification. When the Nullifier appears, name a keyword or superpower. Enemy characters lose and can't gain that power until the Nullifier leaves play. This deck is all about not letting people do what they want to do, and the Nullifier pretty much excels at that. And it's one of a kind, so only one of those in this deck. And since Professor X is all about mental domination, where would we be without a Serpent Crown? One of a kind, unwanted gift, equip the Serpent Crown to an unequipped enemy supporting character, and under Set's control. When you equip this to an enemy supporting character, move that character to your side. When this is unequipped from that character, move it to its owner's side. So it's like having mental domination or Purple Man's brainwash, but it's free, or at least it's a 7 cost. And I can't tell you how much the Serpent Crown has saved my butt in so many games. So it's one of my favorite cards. And it's good for stealing, especially high cost characters that you can't get rid of, like Gilgamesh. As Vern Lee says in the group, if you ain't stealing Gil, that's on you. And I couldn't have said it better myself. So one Serpent Crown. And since we're running Professor X, the X-Man, we've got some X-Men plot twists in here. There's not too many X-Men characters in here, just Iceman and Karma. I think we've got more Brotherhood in here. I'm sure, Professor X's disdain. But since he's our main character, he's often on the board, often face up, and so I can use a lot of these X-Men plot twists. X-Factor, got 3 of these. Just says, ready a character. That's great for characters, the high-cost characters in particular, like getting Fin Fang Foom to attack twice is awesome. Getting Omega Red to attack twice is great. 3 X-Factors. And then 4 protection, 2 find covers, and 2 shocks to the system. It's possible to replace a couple of the one-of-a-kinds or the Quicksilver or whatever with some more of these. Just something to think about. For the last plot twist, 4 copies of Uncanny Defense. Remove a defender on your side from combat and replace it with a different character on your side. Switch their positions. So this one's great for controlling who your opponent attacks. So I've got a proxy in here. This is, I've got 4 copies of, this is standing in for School for Gifted Youngsters, which is the X-Men sort of wild location that I currently have in my Brotherhood deck. So I got 4 copies of that. Got 4 copies of Training Ground for use with the Carbonadium Tentacles or Medusa's Grab, or Spider-Man's Web Sling. We've got 4 copies of Academy, which we want to use liberally on Major Victory's Psychokinetic Shove, of course. All of those Academies should be going towards... Wait, what am I saying? No, it should be going towards stealing characters with Professor X or with Purple Man. Pretty much you want to... Unless you really need to be psychokinetically shoving someone around for some reason, save those Academies, save the intellect locations, because they're better used with, unfortunately, not Major Victory. And finally, I have 4 laboratories, and this is exclusively for Cerebro being able to pull characters from the top 5 cards in your deck is pretty good. Drawing extra cards is great, and finding characters when you need them the most is also really useful. So that is what the laboratory is for. So that's my Professor X, X Major Victory deck. Like I said, I'm disappointed by kind of how bad Major Victory actually is in real gameplay, but it is a joy to bring him out since he's my favorite character. All my friends think I'm weird because of that, and I admit it's weird, but that's the way it is, and I'm just happy to be able to play with him. So thanks for listening, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.